You are watching BitBNS News.
Hello and good morning. Right now, the market is completely volatile. So it is important for the users to get to know what actually happening around the crypto world. What news is there around crypto so far that make sure you watch crypto news daily and keep yourself updated. Terra Classic developers lower burn tax rate to revive ecosystem. Shiba Inu SHIB community urges Binance to list Bon Shiba Swap Bon. Cardano Foundation selects 45 stack pools for delegation out of 188 applicants in October. DeFi has a $4 billion hacking problem. EOS has a solution. Binance denies allegations that it intends to use users' Uniswap tokens for voting. German crypto bank Nuri asks clients to withdraw funds as it goes out of business. Leading digital bank N26 is launching a crypto trading service. $4.5 trillion asset manager Fidelity offers ETH custody and trading to clients. Supra Oracles announces partnership with Matri Protocol. Gaming tokens in Axie Infinity, Chili's and ApeCoin hit by bearish week. Fidelity Digital assets to allow clients trade Ether. US Global Investor CEO reveals Bitcoin mining shuts down globally if BTC hits $12,000. The Terra Classic community has passed a vote to reduce the burn tax as it looks to revive the protocol's on-chain activity. With the vote passed, each transaction will see a tax rate of 0.2% adjusted down from 1.2%. The SHIB army is now pushing Binance and Coinbase to list the governance token. On the top of that, crypto enthusiasts have inked a petition for Binance to include Bon, and it has gained nearly 200 signatures already. According to the announcement, Cardano Foundation received 188 applications for this month's stake pool delegation. One of the 188 applications received, 58 of these pools were selected for their outstanding contributions towards the growth of the Cardano ecosystem. The latest such affair, a $115 million loss by Solana's Mango Market, has brought the total value of DeFi assets plundered to $4.8 billion. October has been the second worst month of the year, with $687 million stolen. Something's got to change, and EOS development team think that they have found a solution that will stop the rot. Crypto exchange Binance denied allegations of misusing its users' token holdings to exercise voting power on the Uniswap Decentralized Autonomous Organization DAO. Binance doesn't vote with users' tokens. In this case, there has been a misunderstanding of what happened during the transfer of a large balance of UNI, around 4.6 million between wallets, a Binance spokesperson told CoinDesk this morning. Digital asset platform Nuri has told customers to withdraw their funds in the next 2 months after taking a hit from the crypto winter. Formerly known as Bitwala, the Berlin-headquartered cryptocurrency bank filed for insolvency earlier this year and failed to find a buyer. N26, a European digital bank, announced on October 20 it is getting into the cryptocurrency space and would be launching a cryptocurrency trading service, with Austria serving as the product's initial market. Fidelity Digital Assets, the crypto wing of $4.5 trillion asset manager Fidelity Investments, is set to offer either custody and trading services to its institutional clients later this month. According to an email to Fidelity customers shared on Twitter, the crypto arm announced new institutional Ethereum capabilities for the institutional investors starting on October 28, 2022.